cylinder's downfall became clear, incredibly, what seemed to concern the administration most was bad PR. This is an email that we're going to show you by a White House staffer from January 31st of this year. It says, quote, if Solyndra defaults down the road, and of course it did, the optics will arguably be worse later than they would be today. A failure of the company will likely coincide with the 2012 campaign season that is heating up, end quote. So they're worried about optics, but not about our taxpayer money down the drain. Well, Brian Ferguson is even more outraged than he was before. Ben Ferguson.
No worries. I'll take that name. I know Brian Ferguson. He's a good guy, so that's all right,
Ben,
with it.
Ben, sorry, it shows you how dumb anchors are. They just read what's on the screen anyway. But does this show, this memo in particular, that what is of greater concern to this administration is the election in 2012 than safeguarding the nation's treasure?
Well, you know, what's interesting about this administration is how they feel like there's some sort of moral imperative to create a green industry that the average Americans can afford. And that's one of the things you saw from these emails, was how important it was for them, for the perception, and from the president directly down his staff, that look, I don't care where you find these companies, I don't care how much money it takes, you've got to spend my tax dollars that I'm in charge of, that I've taken from these American people, and you're going to make sure it's green. Now, when you see these companies aren't making it anymore, you saw as staffers, they're saying, hey, this could bite us in the rear end. This could be bad PR. And I think that's the disconnect. A lot of the American people are going to look at this now in two different phases. They're going to say, okay, one, they wasted $500 million on something. That's not good. The other thing is, they may have known they were wasting $500 million on this company and had warning flags up all over the place, and they still went ahead with it because for some reason they felt like there was a moral obligation that only our dollars can go to green energy. And I think a lot of Americans are going to have a big problem trying to figure all that out and how they can still support the president.
Ben, is this, we're going to be talking about it with our panel, but is this the death knell? Is this the final nail in the coffin of all these government-supported green projects?
Well, I mean, look at, I would say yes. I think the average Americans would say yes. I think there's a lot of Democratic congressmen and senators that would say yes. But what did you hear from the president even today? He mentioned green jobs yet again. What did you hear from people on his administration yesterday? They were talking about green initiative and jobs. And that's the part that I think a lot of people are sitting there going, Mr. President, we just want basic jobs. We don't want green jobs that are costing us hundreds of thousands of dollars to make. And I think that's the part that you're sitting there going,
with
when
companies,
are you going to wake up?
We want jobs with companies that make things that are profitable, not ones that lose money and rely on taxpayer support to survive.
Well, look at the Chevy Volt. They sold 130 units last month. Look at the Green Job Initiative. The president said in his own words, he said, we're going to create 65,000 jobs with billions of dollars. What we found out was they only made about 3,000 jobs from this jobs initiative with green industry, which means you and I paid $600,000 per job that they claim, the Department of Energy claims they created through this green initiative. I'm not willing to pay $600,000 to create one job. I'm not willing to do it, and most Americans aren't either.
All right, we just had Robert Ray on, the former special prosecutor. He says it's too early to tell whether it smells of some kind of lockdown mode in the White House or some kind of smoke screen put up in front of investigators. But he said it's happened before, and he just doesn't know. Have you sensed anything about the way the White House is behaving now in this sort of defensive mode they're in that indicates to you that they've got something serious to hide?
They know. I think that there are a lot of emails and a lot of communication and a lot of things that they're preparing for us to probably get our hands on through some type of leak. And that's the reason why you're seeing them be this defensive. Not since Obama got into office have I seen a White House go into crisis management mode on an issue. They didn't even go into crisis management mode on this point on the BP oil spill. Remember when the president said after 57 days, I'm finally going to find out who's A to kick. I mean, you're seeing more initiative on this scandal than you did with a BP and trying to take that on, and that should have been an easy issue for the White House. So, again, this is one of those, I don't know how you defend it, and the more that we're seeing come out of this, and the more that we're seeing defense by this White House, and they're worried
about
this PR,
that's a great point.
How do you go out there and defend it?
The more you try to defend the indefensible, the worse you look. They've got to get off of that bandwagon if they're going to survive this from the optics point of view. It is amazing that they'd care more about that than save the money. Ben, we got to leave it at that. Ben Ferguson, have a great weekend, my friend. Good to see you. Well,
you
there may
too.
Be
Thanks,
one
Rob.
Silver lining to the Solyndra scandal.